Welcome back to my channel AC2Learn. So this video we will see the MCQ question related with the stability analysis as well as its relevant formulas. First, the amplifier stability is classified into two categories. One is unconditional stability, another one is the conditional stability. For unconditional stability, the criterions are mode of gamma in less than 1 and mode of gamma out less than 1 for all passive and load impedances. For conditional stability, the first condition is same as like unconditional stability, but that is only for certain range of passive and load impedance value. Appo MCQ question la they will ask what is the condition for unconditional stability. Like that they will give number of option and you have to choose this correct option. So this is the way the question will come. And if the transistor is an unilateral one, this is the special case. If a unilateral abdina, power flow in one direction, the meaning is S12 equal to 0. So if you substitute this S12 equal to 0 in mode of gamma in formula, you will get mode of S11. Similarly, when you substitute in mode of gamma out formula, you will get mode of gamma out equal to mode of S22. So if mode of S11 less than 1 and mode of S22 less than 1, if these two conditions are satisfied, then that unilateral device will produce unconditionally stable output. Now, next point is stability circle. So what is this stability circle? Actually, this circle represents the boundary between stable and unstable region in a Smith chart. So if the stability circle eppa varaivanga appadina, suppose the given condition is satisfying only conditionally stable state, then only they draw the stability circle. So in the stability circle la rendu model irukku, one output stability circle, another one is input stability circle. The output stability circle is drawn for the values for gamma L, but the condition is mod of gamma n equal to 1. And for input stability circle, that is drawn for the values for gamma s, and the condition is mod of gamma out equal to 1. And to draw this output stability circle, the center point and the radius is calculated by using these two formula. Similarly, for drawing the input stability circle, the center point and the radius is calculated by these two formulas. So MCQ question la enna kepanga appadina, ipo output stability circle, the conditions are, they will give number of option, you have to choose gamma L, the values for mode of gamma in equal to 1. Like that the questions will come. Now, this is one table based on stability circle, and why I am giving this table means in the question they will give options based on diagram. So in the diagram you have to find out based on the condition whether it is stable or unstable. So for this table you should remember. So for output stability circle, the condition is based on mode of S11. For input stability circle, the condition is based on mode of S22. So mode of S11 less than 1, suppose they are giving this condition in the question. Abina meaning enna abina, nam output stability circle varayirom illaya, and the circle oda inside region unstable but outside region stable. And for mode of S11 greater than 1, stability circle oda inside region stable but outside region unstable. And similarly for input stability circle, for mode of S22 less than 1, inside region of the circle is unstable but outside region of the circle is stable. And for S22 greater than 1, inside the circle is stable but outside the circle is unstable. Now this is one of the example for unconditional stability diagram. Ipo unconditional stability appadina epdi irukum appadina, and the stability circle vandu either it will come out of the Smith chart or it will enclose the Smith chart. Question la they will give this kind of diagram. For unconditional stability you have to choose this diagram. Okay, now this is one of the example for conditional stability. So ipa conditional stability nale meaning enna irukku, namakku input stability circle irukku, output stability circle irukku. So inge keela I mention as output stability circle, but suppose in the question they won't mention, no. So based on the condition you just find it first, idu input circle oda da illa output stability circle oda da. See this, here the condition is provided as mod of S11. Appa mod of S1 nale that is based on output stability circle. So ipo first diagram parunga, mod of S11 less than 1, and second diagram mod of S11 greater than 1. Now see this table. So mod of S11 less than 1 appadina, output stability circle oda inside region unstable but outside region stable. Now see this diagram. outside region is stable, but inside region is unstable. That's why in the condition mod of gamma n less than 1, this is the outside region. Okay, now for mod of S11 greater than 1, S11 greater than na, இங்க பாருங்க previous in this table, S11 greater than mean, inside the circle is stable, but outside the circle is unstable. Now see this, inside the circle is stable. So like that, you have to click the correct option based on the table. And next thing is, for checking this stability, there are two types of test they are following. One is K delta test or roulette condition. Another one is the mu test. This K delta test is based on two parameter. And there are two parameter, K as well as del value. But this mu test is entirely made for one parameter test. But mostly this mu test is not preferred. They will go for K delta test for checking only unconditionally stable output. அதாவது க்வெஸ்சனில் இப்போது இந்த கே டெல்டா டெஸ்ட் இஸ் சூட்டட் ஃபார் வெரிஃபையிங் கண்டிஷ்னலி ஸ்டேபிள் ஸ்டேட்டா இல்லை அன்கண்டிஷ்னலி ஸ்டேபிள் ஸ்டேட்டானா யூ ஹாவ் டு கிளிக் த ஆப்ஷன் அஸ் அன்கண்டிஷ்னலி ஸ்டேபிள் ஸ்டேட் அண்ட் கேல்குலேஷன் ஃபார் கெட்டிங் கே அண்ட் டெல் வேல்யூஸ் திஸ் இஸ் த ஃபார்முலா திஸ் ஒன் இஸ் ஃபார் டெல் டெல் வேல்யூஸ் மோட் ஆஃப் S11, S22 மைனஸ் S12, S21 ஸோ S11, S22, S12, S21 வேல்யூ தே வில் ப்ரொவைட் இன் த க்வெஸ்சன் அண்ட் பை யூசிங் கால்குலேட்டர் யூ ஹாவ் டு find out the value for del. So in the K delta test la, for unconditionally stable output na, they have to satisfy two criteria. One is K greater than 1 and del less than 1. And for mu test, if they followed, for unconditionally stable output means the criterion is mu greater than 1 has to come. So these are the two formula for checking stability. Now based on this, the MCQ questions are, question number 1, for a transistor amplifier to be stable, either the input or the output impedance must have a real negative power. The options are option A true and option B false. Actually, for stable output na negative real part irukkakudadu. So the answer is false. Now the next question is, does condition if met, then the transistor can be impedance matched for any load. The options are conditional stability, unconditional stability, infinite gain, infinite input impedance. Now see this, they provide the condition if met, then the transistor can be impedance matched for any load. எந்த ஒரு விதமான லோடுக்கு இம்படன்ஸ் மேட்ச் பண்ண முடியும்னா, then the condition is unconditional stability. Now the third question, a network is said to be conditionally stable if the options are mod of gamma in less than 1 and mod of gamma out less than 1, mod of gamma in greater than 1 and mod of out gamma out greater than 1, and the third option is mod of gamma in greater than 1 and mod of gamma out less than 1, fourth option is mod of gamma in less than 1 and mod of gamma out greater than 1. See, question they are asking conditional stability. Actually conditional stability na, the point is mod of gamma in less than 1 and gamma out less than 1, and that is for certain range of loading condition. But in the options they doesn't provide certain range, so you have to choose the option that is gamma in less than 1 and gamma out less than 1. So the answer is option A. Now the fourth question is, conditional stability also called as, the options are potentially unstable condition, stable condition, unstable condition and bistable condition. Kandipa stable, unstable, bistable kadaiyadu. The answer is potentially unstable condition. Now the fifth question is, for a unilateral device, condition for unconditional stability in terms of S parameter is, option A mod of S11 less than 1 and mod of S22 less than 1, option B mod of S11 greater than 1 and mod of S22 greater than 1, option C mod of S11 less than greater than 1 and mod of S22 less than 1, option D mod of S11 less than 1 and mod of S22 greater than 1. And I already explained, for a unilateral case the answer is mod of S11 less than 1 and mod of S22 less than 1 for producing unconditionally stable output. Now the sixth question is, if mod of S11 greater than 1 or mod of S22 greater than 1, then the amplifier cannot be unconditionally stable. The options are true or false. Now see this, this is the condition greater than 1. எப்போவுமே நமக்கு unconditionally stable னா less than 1. இங்கே greater than 1 னாலே, of course it cannot satisfy unconditionally stable. So the answer is true. Now the seventh question is, for any passive source termination, gamma is unconditionally stability, implies that the options are mod of gamma out less than 1 and mod of gamma out greater than 1 and mod of gamma in less than 1 and mod of gamma in greater than 1. இங்க பாருங்க, for any passive show termination mod of gamma s இருக்கு. Gamma s அப்படின்னாலே you have to choose the condition as what? Mod of gamma out less than for unconditionally stable. And suppose இங்க வந்து gamma l கொடுத்துருந்தா you have to choose as what? Mod of gamma in less than 1. But in the question they provide as gamma s. So the answer is mod of gamma out less than 1 for unconditionally producing stable output. Now the 8th question, the condition for unconditional stability of a transistor as per K delta test is mod of del greater than 1 and K less than 1. The options are true and false, and the answer is false because K greater than 1 and del less than 1. That's the answer. Now 9th question, if the S parameter of your transistor given are S11 equal to minus 0.811 minus J0.311, similarly S12, S21 and S22 options are there, and then calculate the value for the del they asked. The options are 0.336 and 0.383 and 0.456, and the last option is none of the mention. Actually, to calculate the del value, this is the formula: S11 in the S22 minus S12 in the S21. So நீங்க என்ன பண்ணணும் அப்படினா, calculator complex mode ல செட் பண்ணிட்டு first in the S11 S12 S21 S22 value polar formula convert பண்ணிட்டு, if you substitute directly you will get the answer is 0.336. Now the last question is, the stability circle defines the boundaries between stable and potentially unstable region of, question options are gamma s, gamma l, gamma s and gamma l and gamma out. Actually stability circle ங்கிறது என்னென்ன, boundary between stable and of course potentially unstable region தான். அப்போ அந்த பேஸ் பண்ணி எது பேஸ் பண்ணி வரைவோம், gamma s as well as gamma l. So the answer is gamma s and gamma l. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, kindly subscribe my channel.